Her Up by Sherryl Clark. The dedication reads, For Karen. Chapter 1. Some days I hated Spit Galea so much I wanted to scream. The worst thing was, we used to be best friends. He's lived two doors down from me as long as I can remember, and our mums are friends too. Spit taught me how to hit a softball, and I taught him how to swim. We built a cubby in my backyard when we were 7. Now he hates me as much as I hate him, and I don't know why. He's got a new friend, a horrible little worm called Jason. They hang around together and I stay as far away from them as I can. That way they can't trip me up or call me names or throw things at me. They act like girls have germs and it's all aimed at me. Okay, so we're in different classes this year. First time ever. Our teacher last year, Mr. Loader, said we were nothing but trouble, and I'm sure it's his fault we got separated. We weren't ever really bad in his class, but when he's not shouting, front-end Loader has this really droning voice. One day Spit fell asleep right in the middle of maths. I kept trying to wake him up by throwing paper darts at him and got caught. That was the beginning. Mr. Loader reckoned we did it on purpose, and he started giving us detention for every little thing. So we played tricks on him to pay him back. Dumb, I know. Even Dad said I was smarter than that. Then one day we put superglue on the locks of front end's briefcase, which was bad enough, but when he tried to open it up, his thumb stuck to the glue. Front end couldn't prove it was us, but he knew, and sometimes the looks he gave us sent a crawly feeling up my spine. But none of that explains how Spit and I went from being best mates to sworn enemies. Everything was great before I went away with Mum and Dad over the holidays. By the time I came back, it was the first day of school, and I looked for Spit before class. He was talking to Jason, so I went up and whacked him on the shoulder, like I always did. He spun around with his fist raised, and I backed away real quick. "What do you want?" he snarled. "Just saying hi," I said. "Rack off!" He turned and walked off with Jason. I was left with my mouth hanging open like I was catching flies. I was so embarrassed that all I could do was grab my bag and stroll into class as if nothing had happened. No one said a word to me, and I wasn't going to look like a dumb idiot by asking. June and I sat next to each other on that first day, and in a couple of weeks we were best friends. But every now and then I'd catch sight of Spit glaring at me across the playground, and I'd feel a bit sick, and somehow a bit angry too. It was horrible being dumped, but there was nothing I could do. The first day of March was one of the worst days of my life. June and I were walking home from school, laughing at a dumb joke June's brother had told her. We turned the last corner before my street and Spit and Jason were hiding in someone's front yard with a garden hose. June and I got soaked from head to feet and water leaked into my school bag and all over my environment project. The ink ran and smudged. The project was ruined. Jason laughed and laughed. He's got a stupid cackle that sounds like a rooster choking. That's about what I'd expect from him. But Spit laughed too, and then ran off. My stomach felt like he'd punched me. How could he do that? But even when I saw that my project had been wrecked, I didn't cry. I just got mad. June did cry, though. "My mum'll kill me for getting wet!" So I had to go home with her to help her explain. June's really tall, and she comes from Samoa. She's as tall as I am short, but I can run faster than her. She's always giggling too, but she didn't that day. Neither did her mum. She said she was going to call the school. I tried to tell her it wouldn't help, but you know what parents are like. When I got home, I had to start my project all over again. But all I could think about was how to fix Spit and Jason. I found a clean piece of paper and made a list of ideas. First on the list was...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.